I don't know. I've lost track of time. It's just between you and I, right? That thing's not on, is it? I'm destroyed.
Finally, here we are at the start for the road to Mont Blanc. You've got 1,000 kilometres, definitely the biggest ride I've ever considered undertaking. Yeah, about 21 climbs and just over 23,000 metres of climbing, so yeah, whatever happens, it's going to be epic. I just can't wait to get started now, so yeah, let's do it.
Number 5. So I'd say it's about 8.5k. First one over 2,000 is really tough gradient. It's like double figures almost the whole way up. You know, 13%. So yeah, I've been going 122k. So just trying to stay relaxed and. About probably 100 and maybe 145k in the legs. I've been going just over 7 hours. Time for the night, so yeah, it's starting to get pretty serious now.
How do you feel?
Pretty wet. Yeah, it could be worse. At least the rain is in the valley, so it's a bit warmer. I'm just trying to stay positive. Yeah, that valley leading up to the Stelvio in the rain was just absolute purgatory. It went on forever and like just took so much energy. There's just no chance to recover. And yeah, this climb just is, you know, 7, 8, 9, 10%. We've got about 5k to go. And yeah, looks the weather looks like it's improved quite a lot, so I'm just keeping my fingers crossed that it gets a bit warmer today. I'm gonna try and recover a bit. At the moment it's just pure survival. Highest road pass in Italy, 2,757 meters. Tell you what, that's the slowest I've ever climbed that climb. That's like at least I've got a personal record. It's not for the right reasons, but yeah, it's absolutely, that was so hard. I was dead before I even started it, man. After the Stelvio, and then it warmed up a bit on the Gavia, and then in the valley there, I think I'm solar powered. I feel pretty respectable at the moment, so see how long that lasts, keep my fingers crossed. So probably got about, I don't know, 8 or 9k to the top. It's a big 30k climb, so be good to tick this one off.
That one,
you know, it's a blue sign, and if you look on the Garmin, it follows it right next to it.
Bah écoute, pas mal. Si on arrive à s'y retrouver entre le vert et le bleu.
That's a dead end. That's the highway. That goes next to the highway. Trial and error. Second night is first time I've ever ridden two nights on the trot, so what have we got? We've been out 37 hours and I'm still moving, still in the game. Second dawn, born again. So we've just crested the Nufenen,
We've got two climbs to go, so 19 done, 2,500 meters. Once again, met with a cheeky headwind. Yeah, still got to save a little bit back, but it's a really nice day and it's warm, so get some energy from that. Just got to take it easy on this descent. Don't do anything stupid and long valley section, and yeah, feeling good. About 2k from the top of the four clouds, so still got the montets after this, but from what I can see on the profile, it's gradual. So yeah, this one's good because it's out of the wind. It was the valley section that nearly put me in a box. It was just relentless. So these sort of big wind turbines at the side of the road, it sort of doesn't take a genius to work out what's going on there. Well, the biggest fear that I had really was the double night. There was two moments where I had slight hallucinations on the second night. Yeah, it's pretty crazy, I've only had that once before, and just the most bizarre feeling, and I was just struggling and struggling and struggling. And you know, the Stelvio was just, I was practically falling off the bike at times just through feeling so tired through the cold. And and when we hit the Bonina at 500k, I thought things were hopefully going to get mentally easier, but then we had a headwind for practically the whole way. So it's just mind games. I think physically, if the body is there, then I trained so hard for it, and I'm just learning more about my capabilities and mental strength. I just wanted to do it. I just had to finish. There was never a question. There was never a question in my mind that I was gonna, like, even on the Stelvio, it was like, there's no way I'm gonna not do this. The only way I don't do it is if I crash out and I physically, someone has to put me in the back of a car and it's like, you can't move. Faultless, no punches, no mechanicals, use one bike throughout, and yeah, here we are. I can't quite believe that we made it to Mont Blanc, Chamonix, and yeah, it's a dream come true.